Right, here we go again, guys. Me and Sister Wendy preaching the gospel in Leeds.
Yeah.
Please pray for everybody.
Yes.
Who hears the gospel.
God bless you, Leeds. We have come to tell you the good news that there is hope, there is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Your body contains your soul, which will spend eternity in one of two places, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. God wants you in heaven, and he's asking you only to repent, change your mind, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. The Bible says that we have all sinned, and the wages of sin is death, the destruction of the soul in hell for eternity. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Christ Jesus died on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. If you want to enter into heaven, believe that truly in your heart and call upon the name of the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved. That if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be it whosoever, call upon Jesus, lay hold of your salvation, be sure of your eternal destination, heaven or hell. God wants you in the kingdom of heaven. He is not willing that any should perish in hell. There is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life, the everlasting life. Go to Jesus, lay hold of your salvation. He loves you. Jesus loves you, but he will not force himself upon you. He's knocking at the door of your heart. Jesus said, unless you repent, you will all perish. Unless you become like little children and be converted, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Lay hold of your salvation. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. By the name of Jesus Christ, everyone must be saved. Only by the name of Jesus Christ. No any other name can save you. The name of Jesus Christ is above every other name. It's the name who can save mankind. The name of Jesus Christ gives life. Even if you are sick, by the name of Jesus, you will be healed. Even if you are a drunk person, by the name of Jesus, you must be sober. The name of Jesus Christ, heal every sickness, deliver every man from captivity. The name of Jesus Christ, save life. Jesus Christ is the beginning and the end of life. He's the first and the last. Without Jesus Christ, no one reach heaven. No one enter in the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is paradise. The kingdom of God is a garden of Eden. God is waiting for all men to be judged. Jesus Christ will give you life. Amen.
Yes, go to Jesus Christ. Jesus will not turn anyone away who goes to him. He says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. The Bible makes it expressly clear that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God, and the wages of sin is death, the eternal destruction of the soul in hell. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Who is he that overcomes this world but he that believes that Jesus is the Son of God? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Jesus died on the cross according to the scriptures for all our sins. He was buried and rose again on the third day. If you shall confess the Lord Jesus with your mouth, say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus. Believe that God raised him from the dead. You will be saved. For with the heart, man believes unto righteousness and is justified. And with the tongue, with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Jesus said, whosoever shall be ashamed of me and of my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he comes in the power of his Father with his holy angels. Go to Jesus, lay hold of your salvation. Nobody is guaranteed to be here tomorrow. Nobody is guaranteed their next breath. When you draw your last breath, you will go into eternity, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. God wants you in heaven. He doesn't want you to go to spend eternity in hell. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. For God did not send his Son Jesus into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Jesus might be saved. Go to Jesus, lay hold of your salvation, because Jesus Christ is coming. He's about to descend from heaven with a shout. He will gather up to heaven all who have truly believed on him, all who have laid hold of their salvation. Lay hold of your salvation, for there is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see heaven but through Jesus. Go to Jesus. He loves you. He's knocking on the door of your heart. He wants to give you everlasting life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because of the sin of man, Bible says God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten of himself, Jesus Christ. So whoever believes in him will not perish. God created this world with love. But because of the sin of all men, including myself, God sent his spirit into the womb of a virgin woman, and she gave birth to a holy child. And because of the wickedness of men, they try again to attack the will of God, because the devil don't want us to live in the presence of God. They kill him and they put him into the grave. And the same day, God rose him again, and God put him in the secret place. God hide him from the face of men. The same Jesus Christ knows you. He's coming back. God is bringing him back. No one knows the day. No one knows the time, the hour. We, the preacher, don't even know. But he sent us to you to tell you the judgment is real. Jesus is coming back for the judgment. If you are still alive, you will still be judged. So God will make a judgment. That's why Jesus died. He was crucified for your sin and my sin.
to Jesus Christ, lay hold of your salvation, for there is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man shall see heaven, no man shall see the Father in heaven, but through Jesus, lay hold of your salvation. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. Jesus Christ is coming. We do not know the hour or the day, but we know, just as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also at the coming of the Son of Man. For as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the coming of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage, right up until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Even so shall it be when the Son of Man is revealed. Jesus Christ has come to seek and to save that which was lost. He is the good shepherd. The good shepherd gave his life for us on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again from the dead. If you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. That's the only requirement for you to have your name written in heaven and for you to escape the damnation of hell. Jesus Christ is about to come and take out of this world all who truly believed on him, all who have laid hold of their salvation. Do not take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are, and God wants you in heaven. For God did not send his Son, Jesus, into the world to condemn the world, but that the world, through Jesus, might be saved. Go to Jesus, lay hold of your salvation before it's too late, before you witness many people vanish off the face of the world. They will be taken up to heaven when Jesus descends. He will gather up all believers into heaven in what's commonly referred to as the rapture. Jesus will take all his children up to heaven, and then will start the great tribulation when the Antichrist will reign. The Antichrist will cause all, but small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hands or their foreheads, the mark of the beast. But once you take that mark, that's it. Game over. You'll end up in a lake of fire. God does not want that. He wants you saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved. Be a whosoever. Lay hold of your salvation. For there is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we must be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish in hell, but have everlasting life, and their name shall be written in heaven. The thief, Satan, comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come that we might have life, and that we might have it more abundantly. He is the good shepherd. The good shepherd gave his life for us on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again. You believe that in your heart. Call upon Jesus, and you will be saved. Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes, you will be saved. God always sent every generation, God always sent messenger to warn the whole world. My brother, we preach about Noah. God sent Noah to preach, repent. sin. Jesus loves you.